able to bring that fear out, bring it down, and elevate the spirit, elevate faith as a currency of the spirit. So when you're talking about the spirit, is faith that will be active. Faith is opposite to fear. You can't find fear and faith dwelling together. Right. So what we must do is that faith must be alive. And for faith to be alive, we have to identify our spiritual status. Now, you know, globally, fear is what is prevailing. In our own environment here, you find not only fear, you find violence, also you find hunger. You see, those three are actually to elevate fear above the substance of faith. So we have to look at ourselves and realize, well, first of all, we must not miss the purpose of the season, meaning God is drawing the church to himself. God is calling the church. You know, I used one term last year. I've been praying about reset. I declared it before my friends, and I said, God is calling us to reset. I didn't know that it's going to apply now, that God is calling nations to reset, God's calling individuals to reset. In other words, the way we are going is must not be the way we'll come out.
That's right.
There must be wholesale reset.
That's right.
A reset of structure, of oppression, of paradigm, of understanding. There must be a reset. So that we can be trusted into, you know, something more vibrant and something more viral in God. So the purpose of this season is that God is shutting us down and God is calling us to elevate the family altar, and then our personal dealings with God. Enough of what pastors are telling us, enough of the large corporate gathering. God is calling us to himself and he really wants to visit us, because we are the final lap. Alright, because if you have a global, this is like a global holiday, this is a global race that God allowed. And the impetus is more to the church than even to the world, because those ones are confused. They don't know what to do.
That's right.
God has trashed their system. He has trashed their system. So he has brought them to the good end. They see now that they can't function without God. Even some of them that are non-knowledgeable are realizing about God, realizing that their spirit is beyond us. So more of the message is to the church. In other words, we are having the church we have seen in front has always been the large gathering church. But that's not the true strength of God. The true strength is our personal church. The true strength, the church is the Golgotha church. The true church is the church at the back of the desert. The true church is the one at the mountain that God is refining. So we're not finding God calling everybody back. And what is God trying to accomplish at this season? Christ. The full development of Christ. The scripture says, we've been using Romans 8 so much, from 9, especially emphasis on the level. But the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in you. Dwells in you. That's the emphasis. There must be that dwelling of Christ. The full dwelling of Christ, the full formation of Christ is what God is not going to take for granted. And another said, okay, if God is calling for the full, you know, full development of Christ, frontal, you know, we are powered purely by Christ. That's what he's calling for. You know, another said, if you look at the pandemic, there are key words, I say, with the pandemic. You find the word, you find the word coronavirus. In other words, there is an infection, okay. There's a virus of sin in the church as we speak, you know, that God wants to deal with. Then you find the word quarantine, in other words, an isolation. It means God is calling the church to isolate, and God is telling the church to quarantine. Now, the word quarantine is also using more, even in computer terms, in computer language. You find virus, okay, sort of coronavirus, and then you now find antivirus, which is Christ. And you know, when he wants to take out the virus, he isolates them. He quarantines them to take out sin. So that word is also vital for us, that anger must be quarantined. Fear must be quarantined. Unbelief must be quarantined. Doubt must be quarantined. And then it's deleted. So as I said, if you now find that the substance of anger has always been up, this is the season to deal with them. This is not a season to quarrel. This is a season to be open. It's not a season to engage in fruitless arguments, pointless arguments, pointless discussion about politics. Those are distractions. But this is the time to focus on God and let God do what he wants to do. All of this are God's permission to call his church to himself and deal with those he will use. Right within the church, there's a separation, a demarcation between the two. Those who are have their spirit elevated, who are seen to the corridors of God, who God is working on at this time, working on their inside, observing the principle of the pandemic. There is a pandemic of sin in the church. There's homosexuality, there's bestiality, there's pandemic. The coronavirus is just a representation of a world that's infected by sin. And the sin, you find that virus has capacity to infect, say, by 2 meters. In other words, you find a virus, a microscopic organism, infecting by 2 meters, whereas it's the believer that's supposed to be infected by not just 2 meters, by over 2,000 meters, you'll be able to infect. Finney did it. Captain Kuman in their days, when they lick the lips, you still find the aroma of their presence. Yes, the aroma of Christ there. And I'm now using the illustration. If the same spirit that raised Christ from the dead dwells in us, the same spirit that raised Christ is what is inside us. He said it will quicken, it will make alive our mortal bodies. So this is the time to deal with stubborn sin. This is the time to deal with stubborn ailments, stubborn sickness, stubborn affliction. This is the time for them to be taken away. And this is the time also where our spirit must be above, the faith must be above. And how do we do that? If we find ourselves, because of the threat, you know, even my area, so a few days ago, couldn't sleep. Because they say some 1 million boys are coming, and they are scared everywhere. Might not find that if the fear is elevated, we have to take it out. How do we take it out? All the spiritual protocols must be observed. When I talk about all of the spiritual lessons must be brought out now. You have to understand the power of praise and prayer. You have to understand the power of mental bathing. I call it mental bathing, where you allow the word to soak you, to just begin to meditate on the word and begin to, you know, just begin to, you know, deal the word in. Just allow the word to just wash you and cleanse you. You will begin to deal with those and begin to take them out. And then affirmation and declaration. When you begin to attack from his root and begin to speak to it. And then when you are done with that, you block the avenues of sin. Don't listen to news 24 hours. Don't allow CNN for 24 hours. There's nothing wrong into that, but you have to be careful of the volume of consumption. You have to shut them down and ensure that what is coming in the spirit is more than what is coming from the flesh. Now, if you can hear the news, just take it at different times. Don't take it all around. Take it just to be aware of what is going on. Listen to it as I shut it down. And then give more time to spiritual exercises, the one you listen to and the one you, you know, you open yourself to God to receive. Now, when we do all of that, we elevate our spirit above the flesh. So we are now, it's like a visa to the realm where heaven is cooking something. There's a cooking going on. There's a theater of operation at work now. So by the spirit, we cross into that corridor and we see substances that will last the church to eat for the journey is far. So we begin to eat towards the ministry that is coming after this pandemic. There's a ministry that is coming. There's a revival that is coming. There's a grace that is coming. There's an anointing that is coming. There's impartation that is coming from these dealings as we subject ourselves to the dealings and the details and the demand of this season. So that when we come out, nobody should miss this period. I told them, I said, if you come to this, if you don't understand that God is at work, if you miss this season, if you miss this time, you have missed something vital. And how many times have we seen in the history, you know, in history, where you find a global holiday like this? They said there was a pandemic in 1930 or whatever, or so. It's not like this. It's not like where you're having the major capitals of the world shut down. Is there no way you have mass infection of nations? In this form, that is like a global holiday that's taking place. So if God allowed it, it's for a purpose to draw his church to himself so that we can behold him and become who he wants us to be. So I said, all of this must be observed. And I said something, I'll use one illustration. I used an illustration, I said, if indeed Christ is dwelling in us, remember that we are supposed to carry Christ. We have carried our flesh, we have carried our pride, we have carried our revelation, we have carried all those things in the head of Christ. But that God is called us to carry that is Christ. Now, if you look at the illustration of Mary, you know, when she was pregnant with Christ and he went to visit Elizabeth, I said, from if the coronavirus can travel by 2 meters, Mary entered that place. Distance between Mary and Elizabeth probably is more than 2 meters. But Bible said when he had the salutation of Mary, that Mary was far from him, from her. And immediately she had the salutation, Bible said the baby in the womb of Elizabeth leaked, meaning that the Christ will carry is infectious. The Christ will carry, should be able to travel radius far ahead. Not coronavirus doing that. We believers should be able to infect by 1,000 meters, by 2,000 meters. In other words, the power we carry is going to flow from in out. It's going to flow from inside outside and carry the ability to infect the Christ. The Bible told us that when Elizabeth had the salutation, said the baby lives, and the woman said she was filled with the Spirit. What was doing the work? It was the Christ inside her that was doing the work, touching and impacting Christ in others. And that's where God is calling us to, where the ministry of Christ comes to hold them. Where we assume the default of the humility like Mary and allow Christ to speak. So we carry a speaking Christ, we carry a Christ that is alive, and that's what God wants to see. The ministry that's coming out of this is purely the ministry of Christ. The ministry that we impact out of this, that is coming out of this must be the ministry of Christ. It's no longer business as usual. It's no longer our way. It must be His way. Praise the name of God. I just hear this. It mustn't be the season. It's a season of rest. Amen. It's a season to observe God. It's a season to draw to God. It's a season to hear Him. Mm. It's a season to research. Mm. It's a season to understand. All of the terms are going to be terms that we're going to be using. Mm. Quarantine. Mm. We must quarantine. We must isolate. Mm. We must deal with the pandemic of sin. Homosexuality. We must deal with those pandemic. Mm. You know, and there's also a marking on the forehead. That's what you speak. Those who are able to cross to that Rubicon have been marked. And those who are going to be carried away by this also have been marked. Mm. So this is the time to release ourselves, not to miss God. Mm. There is a purpose for this hour. God bless you.